Good morning, Gotha.
I'm Jack.
I'm Emma.
And this is GTV News You Can Use.
2 years and just like that, my head still takes me back. Thought it was done, but I guess it's never really over. Oh, he was such a mess, but wasn't it the best? Thought it was done, but I guess it's never really over. Just because it's over doesn't mean it's really over. And if I think it over, maybe you'll be coming over again. Enough to get over you all over again.
Each Tuesday will be a spotlight on an awesome student here at Gotha. Our first student is an 8th grader who's an amazing dirt biker. Let's learn about more about Jake Carson.
My name is Jake Carson. I'm in 8th grade and I'm a dirt biker.
How long have you been dirt biking?
I've been dirt biking for about 4 years.
And what do you like so much about it?
The feeling of freedom and that you can control, you're almost always in control of your bike. It's so liberating to be in fully control and going as fast or slow as you want. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime.
And where do you usually dirt bike?
There's a place up in Ocala, the Ocala National Forest, where you can go dirt biking. Great for dirt roads. And up in Georgia, there's a place called Durhamtown, and it's the largest dirt biking tracks. So we go there almost every 4 months.
Do you ever worry about like getting hurt or anything? Have you ever had any bad accidents?
Dirt bike, I mean, getting hurt is a part of dirt biking. So you wear almost like 10 pounds protective gear, so you're pretty ready for any incidents. But I've had my fair few of crashes. I go dirt biking with friends a lot, and it's a good experience. But the best part about it is connecting with my dad and grandpa. It's so unique, and I'm so fortunate that I have a grandpa that can go dirt biking with me.
Wow, how old is your grandfather?
I believe he's in his 80s.
And he dirt bikes?
Yes, he's very active, per se, for his age.
That's amazing. What else do you like to do in your free time?
Free time, I like to build things when I'm bored. I'll work on my dirt bike or work on the car we're restoring. It's fun to make things with my own hands.
Do you know what you want to be when you grow up?
Absolutely. I want to be an aerospace engineer for the Air Force.
Awesome. For the Air Force. Okay, and what do you have to do to become an aerospace engineer for the Air Force?
Well, first you'll either have to go through college and get a degree in engineering, math, or STEM. Or you can go through the Air Force's own academy and they'll set you up for what you want to do. And then you'll either have to apply at the Air Force or a company that could get a contract from the Air Force, Lockheed Martin or Boeing. And hopefully you can work your way up through the ranks and become an engineer.
And how do you know so much about all of this?
Well, my grandpa was an engineer, so I always look up to him and he goes dirt biking with us, and it's just a fun family tradition.
Okay, and do you think you'll have to have really good grades in order to accomplish all of this?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, all these companies are just looking for the best and brightest, so I mean, if I keep going and study hard, then hopefully I'll make it. One shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better. This soul's escaping through this hole that is gaping. This world is mine for the taking. Make me king as we move toward a new world.
It's a great day to be a Grizzly.
That's all we have for today, Gotha. I'm Emma.
I'm Jack.
And this is GTV News You Can Use.